We are a long come forth drive to begin our service together. There are schools along this site, and this is where we begin our greeting. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. I'm here at the library, and we come together to say what's commonly known as the Collect for Purity. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So you can see we're approaching the GPs and the pharmacy. The red hotspot tag is hopefully still there. Yes, it is. And now we go and find Mike and Eve.
If my people, who are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, and I will forgive their sin, and will heal their land.
We have not always worshipped God, our Creator. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We have not always followed Christ, our Saviour. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. We have not always trusted in the Spirit, our guide. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
So I'm here at one of the many bus stops on our estate, and we come to be assured of God's forgiveness to us. May the Father forgive you by the death of his Son and raise you to new life in the power of his Spirit. Amen. Out of breath because I've just climbed the road to come to the entrance to the nature reserve, which has the Severn Trent reservoir at the top. We're going to head up the steep part, and Chris is going to lead us in today's collect. Father, you have invited us to share in the supper which your Son gave to his church, to proclaim his death until he comes. May he nourish us by his presence and unite us in his love. Amen. Phil and Keith are going to help us with our gospel reading today. Phil is reading to us from outside a block of flats on the Tullodine Road, and it's marked down on the thanks track as a rubbish clue. And so I am here just about to join Phil for our Bible reading, and I'm alongside the wheelie bins, and the clue for the wheelie bins is all the way over there where Chris is at the tree. There is a red card there, I promise, and it's even survived the storms this week.
Now on that same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What are you discussing with each other while you walk along?" They stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days?" He asked them, "What things?" They replied, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was all one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since all these things took place. Moreover, some of the women of the group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us to the tomb and found it was just as the women said, but they did not see him." And he said to them, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory? Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself in all the scriptures."
So you can see we are here outside the Warnden Clinic, and Keith is going to bring us the second part of our reading.
As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, "Stay with us, because it is almost evening and the day is now nearly over." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening the scriptures to us?" At the same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem, and they found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying, "The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon." Then they told what had happened on the road, and how he had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you."
We've just arrived outside the Oasis School, chasing the rain, hoping that we can beat it, and Chris is going to bring us our New Testament reading.
The Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
And so at the sorting office, where all of the post has gone out from in all of these tricky days, people of God, people of life, we gather as a holy communion for a meal that has been shared countless times, in countless places, in countless ways. The first time this meal was shared, Jesus gathered around a table with a ragged collection of people, outcasts, betrayers, the power hungry, the fragile, the lost. The first time this meal was celebrated, Jesus promised that it was for all time, that whenever the bread was broken and the wine was poured, wherever the story was told around a table, he would be there. Today, as we remember the story, as it's been told 1,000 times over, and we treasure the bread and treasure the wine, we affirm that we all belong at his table and that Jesus is here wherever we are. We are a holy table with food to fill a hungry world and wine to quench thirsty hearts. So we're right in the middle of the houses, and Chris is going to help us with our creed today, our statement of what we believe to be true about the God who made and loves us.
Let us declare our faith in God, saying, we believe in God the Father, from whom every family on heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
So, as you can see, we are now at the community centre, and Brian is going to be leading us in our intercessions.
That this day may be holy, good and joyful, we pray to you, O Lord, that we may offer to you our worship and our work. We pray to you, O Lord, that we may strive for the well-being of all creation. We pray to you, O Lord, that in the pleasures and pains of life we may know the love of Christ and be thankful. We pray to you, O Lord, that we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit in communion with all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ. We pray to you, O Lord. Let us commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. Amen.
And so at the south end of Crown and Parade, we come to share the peace with one another. Christ came to proclaim the gospel, peace to those who are far off and peace to those who are near. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a socially distanced sign of peace. So I'm here at the north end of Crown and Parade. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
I'm here outside the Vets on Ambleside. It is always right to give you thanks and praise, God our Creator. Loving and faithful, holy and strong. You made us and the whole universe and filled your world with life. You sent your Son to live amongst us, Jesus, our Saviour, Mary's child. He suffered on the cross. He died to save us from our sins. He rose in glory from the dead. You send your Spirit to bring new life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And so, we join the angels to celebrate and say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Father, on the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took bread. And thanked you. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." After the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He thanked you and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this to remember me." And so on the orbital pedway, we come to our acclamation with the dogs barking all around me. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. So we are on the recreation ground behind the Oasis School, and we are continuing with our Eucharistic prayer today. Father, as we bring bread and wine and remember his death and resurrection, send your Holy Spirit that we who share these gifts may be fed by Christ's body and his blood. Pour your Spirit on us, that we may love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we wait for his coming in glory. For honour and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus your Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. I'm here outside St. Joseph's School and Church. You can probably just about see the red tag on the lamppost to the left. We were planning that we were going to share the Lord's Prayer here, but the weather's been so bad, Canon Stephen Edwards shares the Lord's Prayer for us in the rain in the vicarage garden instead.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
We break bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. As you can probably tell by this enormous sign, we are at the Little Tesco's just off Cotswold Way. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us your peace. Amen. Well, as you can see from the image behind me, I'm on the canal right by Tolladine Lock. And I wanted to say a few words as we come to the moment in a service where normally I would be with you and I would be able to take bread and place it in your hands and say to you, the body of Christ broken for you. Sometimes the words we use are the body of Christ, the bread of life. Sometimes we use the very traditional language, the body of Christ given for you. Preserve your body and soul unto everlasting life. It doesn't really matter what form of words we use. In fact, in this current climate, when bread is given to you in person, the idea is that words are not spoken over you to keep things safe. On normal days, I would then be able to give you the wine, or Mona, or Phil, or Brian, or Georgie. And they would say to you, the blood of Christ shed for you, or the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation, or maybe that very traditional language, the blood of Christ shed for you, preserve your body and soul unto everlasting life. We don't have bread to share with you directly today, and we don't have the cup to share directly. But how many times have we shared that meal together as family around the table? There's something which has been a tradition in the church for many, many centuries. It's called spiritual communion. And it's the idea that when you're not able to participate fully in a communion service, I don't think it was anticipated it would be because of pandemic, but when you're not able to take part fully, that you're able in your heart and your mind and your soul to be there as if receiving the bread, to be there as if receiving the wine. And so a moment of silence, and then I invite you to make a spiritual communion. And so, the body of Christ, broken for you. Amen. The blood of Christ, shed for you. Amen. We're pretty much now at the end of our service together, and the hot spot that we're at on the thanks track is the one with the probably most enigmatic clue. It says red cranes, but if you look, you'll see that the symbol for Cranham Primary School is a red crane. And so with the red tag on the lamppost on the left-hand side of this picture, Chris and I come to say the prayer of sending out at the end of our service. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. I'm here at lamppost 4897. In the middle of the factories and workplaces on Buckholt Drive. I think it's the first of our locations where the red hotspot tag for the thanks track hasn't seemed to have survived intact. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The first commandment is this, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Amen. Lord, have mercy. I'm standing here right by the trolleys at Lidl, in the middle of so many shops which bring people into our community, give employment and resources to us all. And it seems a very fitting place to pronounce our blessing at the end of our service. May you be safe. May you be set free from fear. May you be as happy and as whole and as healthy as it is possible for you to be. And may you know kindness and goodness in difficult days. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and all those you long to embrace, now and forever. Amen. So Brian's going to help us finish our service as we stand here at the petrol station on Blackpool Road.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.